Are you always angry, or at least feel like anger is the first way that your body tries to problem solve an issue? Is your boss giving you feedback? Is your family giving you feedback that you're too angry, or you get angry too quickly? Have you lost relationships because of your anger? If any of this is true, then this is the video for you. I'm going to talk about the brain, the origins of anger inside the brain. I'm going to talk about strategies that you can do in the moment to cut the anger. And then I'm going to talk about amazing technology that helps the brain register when it's going into an anger response and stop it. So, anger is part of our most primitive brain functioning, it is part of our survival instinct. And the whole point of anger is to stop harm from occurring. So the question, of course, is, well, why do I start screaming at my spouse? I know they're not trying to hurt me, or my boss, or that person at the light who didn't move quickly enough when the light turned green. How come that is the reaction my body has if it's supposed to only get angry in times when I'm not safe? That question is a very important one to discuss when you think about strategies for stopping anger. So the origins of anger inside very deep inside the core of the brain. So our limbic brain, our brain stem, that's our survival brain. This prefrontal cortex, that's our higher functioning brain. That's the part of the brain that contemplates, that can stop emotions, that can think before we speak. It's our responsive part, whereas anger comes from the reactive part of the brain. So, what happens for us? Why do we develop these long-term anger habits? Is because that our brains, we understand in mental health, form habits. We form habits of thought, but the brain also forms neural pathways that are habitual. And specifically, this fight, flight, freeze, survival brain, as it's called, is very good at forming habits. In fact, if you look at an MRI, it shows you that information goes from that primitive brain, that survival brain, out to our prefrontal cortex to give information, and that there aren't as many neural pathways going from our prefrontal cortex to communicate commands to that more primitive brain. And that is because survival is the most important thing. If a bear is charging you, you do not want to contemplate whether you should run or punch it. You want the body to just react in a millisecond in order to survive. So what happens is that survival mechanism of that fight response, anger, becomes a habitual strategy, and the brain just uses it, not recognizing that A, it's not a situation where it's warranted. Nobody's coming at you with a knife. And number two, it's not an effective strategy for problem solving. Because often, as we know, we get hurt feelings, we get greater misunderstanding, we get less cooperation, we get a less likelihood that we're going to get what we want. So, now let's talk a little bit about strategies. So, if you know that you get angry in certain situations, you should prepare yourself for that. You should talk to yourself and say, you know what? I'm going to see this colleague, they totally annoy me. They often are a source of me saying something nasty and reactive. When I get there, I'm going to, instead of focusing on what they're saying that's annoying, I'm going to focus on my breath, or I'm going to focus on something in the room that is a different thing, something I don't normally focus on. When we give the brain the opportunity to see the present moment in a fresh way, that's a way that the brain can register the current environment as safe and so less likely to go into an anger response. If you don't trust yourself in a situation and you notice you're getting angry, just get up. Get up and walk away. Go to the bathroom. If you can, get a very cold compress. That is a great way to change states for the nervous system. So, you know, if you have the opportunity to have like face cloths in your freezer or a dry ice pack, right, and just break it open and put it on the back of your neck, it's a terrific way to change states immediately. For a more kind of less immediate, longer term, so you're noticing you're starting to get annoyed, you can't leave, you can start doing what's called box breathing. And box breathing is a form of focusing on your breath and counting. So you inhale to four, hold for 4 seconds, and exhale for 6, 7, however many for the exhale. To have the exhale longer than the inhale is another way that we use the breath to trigger that brain to register. It's a safe environment. Don't use that fight energy. If you're at the state having an anger problem where it's causing you the potential to lose your relationship, to lose a job, to lose friends, I'm going to recommend something that's a more longer-term intervention, a more expensive intervention, but it's definitely an effective one, and that is neurofeedback training. Because neurofeedback training is a form of brain training that specifically uses the brain waves and measures them to let that brain know when it's going into a fight, flight, freeze state. And that brain, when it registers that it's going into that maladaptive fight response, it cues it, and then the brain has the opportunity to change states and calm down. And when you do a series of brain training sessions, so let's say 3 sessions a week for 3 months, you're literally giving your brain the training it needs to come out of that habitual reactive anger response to create the space for this prefrontal cortex to be the part that's in charge. So then your communication can go from being reactive to being responsive so that you can be thoughtful. Your body's not reacting so that you can think about your answer. You can listen to the other person. You can be open. You can have a different, better emotional range when you're interacting with others. So please leave a comment if you have one. Subscribe to the channel if you're interested. We have lots of videos on brain health, emotional regulation, and neurofeedback.